Welcome to my stream. Welcome. Today we are streaming again from the emulated Amiga that I have on my PC. So that's why you don't see the second camera with a classic Amiga 1200. Welcome Livelord, and welcome SLD Snake. Thank you for being here. It's Friday for AmigaOS stream, right? Perfect day for an AmigaOS stream. How are you doing, guys? So today we are going to see some exciting things, and actually it is going to be an experimenting stream because I didn't prepare anything. So the reason that I'm hello Dota 1200, thank you for the hosting, thank you very much. The reason that I'm going to use the emulated Amiga today is because we are going to create a beautiful workbench. So we are going to see how we can use high graphics, big resolutions, skins on Windows, and even if we can, to make it look much better. But this needs, of course, a Picasso graphics card, which I don't have on my 1200, or something that works like that. And also it needs a more powerful machine. So we are going to see on the emulated. We are going to prepare an emulated Amiga, which will be able to support this kind of hardware, to emulate this kind of hardware. And we are going to see how we can make our Amiga beautiful, like the ones that you might see the installations for Raspberry Pis, okay, like AmiKit or something like that. Livelord, you are still at work? Okay. Friday is going to... Friday work is going to end for you soon. SLD Snake says, beautiful workbench. I always think on powerful and RTG Amiga. Yeah, this is what we need to have something like that working fine on Amiga, because we need RTG graphics, okay, and we need big resolutions. And of course, a powerful Amiga for the icons and all the refreshing of the screen. Livelord, I hope that you are going to end the work soon, so go and rest and have fun for the weekend. So let's see how we, I don't know if you remember, but I was using on my first streams the emulated Amiga. So still has IMP 1 version 1 installed, so I didn't do any update on that. Let me reset it and let's see how it goes. Okay, if you remember, we emulated in Amiga 1200 with Blizzard 1230, pretty much like the classic Amiga that I have. Okay, SLT Snake, no problem at all. See you later. And we need something more powerful, so we are going to change a few things here. First of all, let's create some graphics, put some graphics RAM. Let's say 32 megabytes of graphics card. This option will also enable the RTG on our Amiga. If you remember on previous from previous streams, we installed actually the Picasso because we wanted to use the native driver and gain some cheap RAM. So we have a Picasso installed. So by checking this checkbox on FS UI, we are going to enable the graphics card. And let's see what else we can use. At first, let's create this installation with Picasso. Okay. And that's the only change that we done. Let's start it. And if we see that the O30 is not so powerful, although that here we have JIT installed, so enabled. So it should be fine, but we will see. If the O30 is not as powerful as we want, we might change it later. But first, let's see if we can enable the Picasso and make the workbench to work in bigger resolutions. That's our first goal. Okay, so if we go to devices and monitors, currently we have only native, so we need to, let's see the preferences, if we can see the higher resolutions. Screen mode, no, there's nothing like that. So we need to have, let me find Picasso, and let me check on storage if we have any extra. Yeah, we have this one. If we double click that, yeah, we need from for Picasso to be enabled, if I'm not wrong, a monitor file, although the one that exists is pretty much dummy, but there is one, I might be wrong, but there is one on the Picasso that are freely available on Aminet. So let's let's extract that file. Where is it? Picasso here, this one. To RAM. And check if there is the Picasso for the UI. Livelo says this is interesting. I'm running my workbench on 040 with ZZ9000 and fonts are my biggest issue. Specifically in CLI, as I can use Helvetica in system. CLI uses fixed fonts and I can't find good enough replacement. Okay, we are going to see how we can use true type fonts on the Amiga, and we will see how we can enable them to use the anti-aliasing so that they look pretty good. And so bear with me, Livelord, because we are going to see how we can play with the fonts. Okay. And how we can use them in the browser, for example, so we can have a better look of the websites. But first, let's make Picasso work fine on UI. So in devices, I'm trying to find the RTG, the Picasso monitor for the UI right now. No, it's not there. Preferences. It's not there. So, as I said, nothing is prepared. So, we are going to do it together. Yeah, there is this graphics card here. Picasso. And let me go to storage, take this one, move it to monitors, and from here, yeah, we had the UI graphics in the storage. Let me move it here, double click, and see if enables the bigger resolutions. Not. No, it doesn't. And let's see if we need drive. Oh, not here. Where is it? Okay, monitors. Picasso 96, this UI graphics card. Let's see where we need to install it. Possible we need to install it here or in here. So let me do a reboot and we will see how it goes. Hello, Aris Amiga. Welcome to the stream. Welcome to the stream. And yeah, as soon as we make that work, we are going to use another package that comes from AfAOS, and it is called AfAOS for Amiga. It is a quite old package, but possibly it works fine for our system. So this didn't work. Let me extract again the Picasso. Package. This one. What would you say? Should I install it above the previous version or continue to find a way to do it manually? Actually, if we have, I don't remember what actually, yeah, we have Snoop DOS here. So if I try and load the monitor devices, monitors, this one, it will show if it doesn't, somewhere fails. Okay. Yeah, libraries Picasso 96, that's the place that is looking for the driver. So it was wrong that I put it inside here. Let me move it. And let's go to libraries, and here it should be a folder named Picasso 96. Great, let's put this in here and let's try to run again the monitor. And see if it works or it needs a reboot. But before that, clear buffer. Okay, I cleared the list of the Snoop DOS, and okay, now it is found. Screen mode. Oh my god, we don't see that again. So let me reboot again. Sometimes it needs a reboot so that it works on start. Hello, Amiga Gamer 1200. Welcome to the stream. Today on this stream, we are going to see how we can make AmigaOS 3.2 have great graphics in high resolutions and some million of colors. And we try to, that's why I'm streaming from my emulated Amiga that I have on my PC, because on my classic Amiga I don't have any Picasso, and we are going to see how we can put skins on the windows and make it work with bigger and nicer icons. So for now, the first steps that we try to do is, because we had the Picasso drivers installed in this machine, we try to make it work with the UI and get some bigger screen modes. But unfortunately, it fails for some reason, unless I did something stupid in my configuration. Let me restart the emulator, because I didn't have the graphics card here enabled, so this might be the reason, I guess. And let's start it again and see if it works. Amiga Gamer 1200 says much faster RTG on emulation. Yeah, it is much faster. That's why. And my 1200 with the poor O30 is not going to be that good for the stream. It is going to be really slow. And of course, the things that we are going to do today are not supported, because it requires RTG. For now, the emulated Amiga that I'm using here has an O30 CPU, but the JIT is enabled, so it should be fast. If not, we are going to see how we can increase that to a better CPU and how AmigaOS 3.2 is going to behave. Let's see as soon as it boots. And yeah, the goal today is to make even the AmigaOS 3.2 to look closely to AmigaOS 4, and with nice icons, and we will see if we can achieve that. As I said earlier, the stream today is going to be experimental, because I didn't prepare anything on that. So bear with me, and if we have issues, we are going to solve them together. So yeah, the UI is, the Picasso graphics card is enabled. So as you can see, we have bigger resolutions here. We can go even to 1080p resolution with 32-bit of colors. Let's see how it goes. And then, yeah. Everything is so small, so I will go with something smaller, if you don't mind, so that it is visible on the stream as well. I will say 1024 to 768. A nice 4:3 resolution, right? Okay, and I will increase the where they are, the fonts, so that they are visible on the stream as well. Let's see the, but we are going to try to use better fonts, like TrueType fonts in our Amiga, so we can have anti-aliasing and have all these better looking fonts in our machine. Let me increase it more. We have Helvetica here. Let's use that. Topaz 11. And the screen, Helvetica 15. And see if that looks better. How it looks, guys? What do you think? Is it readable? Let me adjust a little bit the screen. Liverlord, you are on a lag. It is slow. Do you guys see any problems with the stream? Please tell me, otherwise I can see if that comes from me. Liverlord says, you're right, Amiga Gamer 1200, that backdrop sucks. I removed it shortly after installing Workbench 3.2. Ah, it's okay, Liverlord. Okay. Yeah, the backdrop is bad for this resolution and this number of colors. Give me a few seconds to adjust a little bit the screen so it is looking better on the stream, if that's possible. Okay. I hope it looks better now, and yeah, we are going to make it look even better. Yeah, for now, it looks nice. At least we have a big resolution with bigger fonts, and let's see, for example, the IBrowse. If you remember, now it is, we have more space and the window is smaller. We have a lot of colors in images. If we go to a website, the website looks much better. The images, okay, and the photos. For example, this one is a million of colors, so it's much better, yeah? Hey, SLT Snake. Hello, hello again. Welcome back. So it is good. Let's, the first thing that we might want to do is to change the background, right? Let me find something nice that I might have here. I have a lot of wallpapers in my Amiga, sorry, in my PC. So let me find something and put it there. Okay. So if we go here, preferences and workbench pattern, select picture, I will essentials, this one, we are going to select to be scaled, best, test, I hope you like it. It's not the best scaling that happened here. Let me see if there is a better mode. There is scaled, there is interpolated, tiled, centered, scale. If we do that. Yeah, because the image that I choose is 1080p, so it doesn't scale that good. Let's see how it goes now. Didn't change much. Scaled. Unless I do it as a standard. So it is not going to scale it, but it will fill the window. SLD Snake says, have you seen the new Metal Gear parody game Unmetal? It's very good. Amiga Gamer says that, yeah, to SLD Snake. Yeah, so let's leave it as it is. But we have here the problem that we can't read the fonts, and this is something that we can change from the font, of course, workbench icon text. And we can set them as white. And here we have a text field. It is a background on the a background color on the text, or outline, or shadow. I prefer the shadow with a black shadow. Save, and that's pretty good right now, I believe. So our next step is to bring the better looking windows, to change the borders with the skin. For that we can do it with Birdie and Visual Prefs, but there is also the AFA loader, which is coming from AROS, and this the name is AROS for Amiga, which brings much better features, and also it has the ability to use TrueType fonts. So I will use that package. But before I do that, if you remember, we had previously installed Visual Prefs here, and I think that it is running. So let me stop that from working. In startup sequence, we have somewhere here or not. VPrefs. Let me search for that. Yeah, here it is. We were running the Visual Prefs. So I'm going to comment that out like that and save it. And then I'm going to, do we have Scout here? No, let's reboot. And the next thing, we are going to start IBrowse and download AFA loader. This is a patch, of course, but I never before used it with AmigaOS 3.2. So it might work, it might not. Let's see. Let's experiment. And IBrowse, Aminet, and we can search with alpha. Okay, the version that we are looking for. Let me see. Actually, if I recall right, it is 1.8, the latest version. 4.8, this one. AfAOS 4.8. Let's download it. And extract it to the memory. So here, internet. Downloads AfAOS 4.8. It is a big package. It has some AfAOS libraries, some exe files that do the patching to the different parts of the AmigaOS. And this is the one that we are going to try. But it is a pretty good and a solid solution for what we need to do, and it has also a lot of skins coming with the package. So let's see the readme. It has a real-time skin system. It can be selected between visual prefs. Yeah, otherwise if you don't use the arrows for Amiga OS, you have to install visual prefs, Birdy, and then find some skins to use them. And also you have to use some libraries, different libraries for TrueType fonts. But the AfAOS project has everything inside. If I'm not wrong, this project patches also the icons. So we might want to skip that, and we will see how it is done. It has also some preferences files to change things. And it has 22 skins from Ken Lester. So let's go and see how it works. And if it works, because it might fail. Okay, proceed. Where do you want to install the test programs and documentation? Directory called AfAOS will be created for you. Let's put it inside, I will say, system. So right now, what it does, it installs some files here in presets. You will see there is a new folder named skins. And here are all the themes that are supported by, are copied by the AfAOS with different sizes and things like that. So you must add and maybe change some lines in your startup sequence to use AfAOS on boot. Please read and follow the installation instructions or the documentation. Okay. Don't forget to deactivate power icons. Power icons. Well, it was a software that was used a long time ago. It was the first program that introduced the a way to use PNG images as icons in the AmigaOS. But yeah, it is not maintained for a long time now, and the AfAOS replaces that. Okay. Not all files are copied with installer, so take a look on the archive dir. Okay, installation complete. So we have the skins in the presets. And let's skip that at the side. And inside system folder, we have to have the AfAOS here. Okay. And let's see what we need to add in the startup sequence. Installer AfAOS installation. Okay, please use the installer to install on your system. The files user startup and startup sequence usually are located in the S. So we need to run more lib space and the AfAOS loader. More lib space, if I'm not wrong, is a path that adds some more size for the icons library or something like that. Let me check. If possible, the first, okay. Yeah, it doesn't explain here what it does, but if you go to the did the installation work here, it says that if possible check the in scout the more lib space is working properly, look for selection library, click on icon library. If icon library has 10,000 bytes of positive lib space, then it's working properly. It adds some memory for the library, if I'm not wrong. So what we need to do is see more lib space as the first line in our startup sequence. So open S startup sequence, and first, before everything, we are going to do see more lib space, and after that I will reboot and see if that breaks anything. SLT Snake says, I still have AFA in my to-do list, but I think I have read maybe at the app that it has some issues with 3.2. Not sure. I didn't see that mention that you say, SLT Snake. But possible, it breaks AmigaOS 3.2. Let's see, experiment here. As I said, I didn't try it before, so let's see how it works. And if it fails, this stream is going to be a very good guide maybe for the developers of AmigaOS 3.2 to see what we do and how it fails. But it might work, or we might not need to patch everything, right? Because the icon library of AmigaOS 3.2 is much newer than the one that was public released when the AfAOS was released. So we might not need to patch the icon library, if it is possible to exclude that. So for now, the more lib space seems to work, and now we need to start the AfAOS loader. Let's go here, where is the documentation, and see how we can do that. And and let me open again the text edit. Actually, I should move the text edit down here. Why not? Okay. And let's open the startup sequence. AfAOS installation, more library, and AfAOS loader. Insert the following line, see AfAOS loader after beneath the add data types. Okay. Here. You see it is the same place where we were using the visual prefs. AfAOS loader, what it does is it searches about the folder AfAOS, which we installed in system, and goes here and then loads. Where they are? No. Are they here? Yeah. Sorry. It goes here in sys and loads these libraries, which are the actual patches. So if we need to disable something from here, let's say the icon library, if I recall right, we just need to rename the library, for example, add something at the end of the name, and this is going to be disabled. So right now I have the AfAOS loader in my startup sequence. Let's restart and pray. SLD Snake says, yes, the 3.2 binaries are newer, so maybe there are some needless patching. Yeah, yeah, we will see. If it fails right now to boot, we are going to boot in a safe mode, disable it, or disable some of the patches, and we will see where it fails. It's a good example to see how we can debug things like that, right? Which is something that we love to do here in this stream. And it takes some time. Possible fails. And I will propose to go with step-by-step booting of the system. So let me reboot it and keep the two mouse buttons so I can go to the early startup. Okay, and let's go to trace startup sequence. SLT Snake says, good practice, testing and learning. That's why this stream is here. So if it fails, at least it will fail for me. And you are not going to ruin your installations. So we want to run the more library space. Here you have the selections, return, del, and escape. Escape, if you press escape, is going to continue with the booting without pausing in every step. If you go with a return, it will execute this line. If you go with the del, it will not execute this line. So we are going to execute each line and see where exactly it fails. Okay. Okay, if not worn, add buffers. If we see the add data types after that, if you remember, it is the alpha loader. Make dir, resident, assign. Okay. We are getting close. Unset the workbench. Okay. Add data types, and after that we have alpha loader. Yes, it's run it. So the first one, alpha system lib, it runs this exe file, picture, disk font, exec, graphics, icon, intuition, and then continues with ipress. So it seems that everything's running fine, but fails on ipress. After iprefs. Okay, what I would suggest is to disable a couple of the libraries and see if we can make AfAOS boot fine on our system, and then enable one by one and slowly see if it works or not. SLD Snake says, trace startup sequence was a good new feature for these situations. Exactly. Exactly. I don't know if there was an alternative way to do exactly that. If you were using something like that, please tell me. What I have seen was to put an echo on at the top so that it prints out the each and every line on your system and see exactly where it breaks, but you don't have the selection, the option to not run something if you want. Everything runs all the time. So what I'm going to do here is disable some of these patches. Let's see if we can disable this one. Actually, I'm going to remove them from this folder. Let's create another folder here. Say AfAOS backup. We can move that to storage, for example, later. And I will move there the icon library, the picture data type. Hello, Perseda, welcome to the stream. Hello, JMA80, welcome to the stream. Trace seems a very useful feature. How failsafe boot works? Failsafe is what you see here. It boots to the workbench, but as you can see, we don't have the big resolution right now because most of the drivers are not loaded. But it gives you a way to use the workbench and fix the problems that you might have. And you can also open the text edit and other programs that you might need. Especially text edit because you might want to edit your user startup. SLD snake, yes, MMM, and echo and a pause before the end. Maybe I'm confused with MS-DOS. Yeah, the solution like the echo, it was on MS-DOS as well. Yeah, but SLD Snake says maybe wait command instead of pause. Yeah, but you have to go and do that yourself. Okay, so if you wanted to have so many wait commands, although that wait, if I'm not wrong, it waits for some seconds. But anyway, that feature was not something that I have seen in any other way to be able to happen. So right now I removed those libraries here. Let's see, because I'm curious, if there is something in the documentation of AfAOS for debugging or what we need to disable in case we have problems. Programs that do not function with AfAOS, FAQ, what is AfAOS? Okay. Let's check the not this FAQ disk font icon lib. Okay, let's have a look. Let's reboot and have a look. Look at that, we booted. So one of these libraries are failing with the AmigaOS 3.2. Okay, the other one seems to work. Let's see if we can do something with the preferences of the program. Where are they? They are not here. Are they in the system? Here. The installer does not. Maybe the installer does not copy that. So let me do it again. Volumes, system, internet, downloads. We have some progress. And see, let's see if we can succeed, right? Now I don't know how good AfAOS is working with AmigaOS 3.2, but I have used that with 3.9 before, and it is a very good package, to be honest. And I think that AmiKit and all these packages are using this one. All these distributions. So let's see how. Yeah, here they are. Let me move them to prefs. Okay, they were here, but they didn't have any icon. Anyway, let's see. Of course, the icons are not looking good because, first of all, we don't use the patch for the icon library. If you remember, we removed it. And secondly, we will see maybe they are not having all the information that is needed in the icon, so we can use other icons later. But first, let's see if we can do something here. Save first system. Icons, window. Yeah, they are not enabled. And text. I don't know if it is possible to see that on the stream, but the text here has some anti-aliasing. Let me see if I can increase it. Oh, that's decreasing. You see that it changes, so I believe that this thing is working. Font size adjust. Okay. So now for the window, it is not enabled. Possible this is not enabled because it's missing something. Maybe the picture data type, it is needed. So what I'm going to do is enable safer system. Or no, first of all, before I do anything, I want to be sure what if the picture data type makes the AfAOS fail on boot. So right now I moved it again inside the libraries folder, and I'm going to reboot to see if the Amiga still boots. If it still boots, then the problem was the icon patch from AfAOS, and the data type is going to run just fine, and see if we can, yeah. And let's see if we can play with the skins. Okay, and the skins are still disabled. But why? Okay, I'm a little bit confused right now. Let's see the documentation if it has some information. Or I missed something on the installation. Okay, possibly I did something stupid. AfAOS installation. Okay, for the skin system support. When activating the AfAOS skin system, it is possible that some display errors may occur. Okay. If you have installed Birdie or Visual Prefs, please make sure that your startup sequence allows you to switch Birdie and Visual Prefs on and off. please compare your settings with AmiKit startup sequence. Yeah, AmiKit startup sequence uses some environment variables to see if it needs to run the Birdy and Visual Prefs or not, or use the AfAOS. Okay. When the string gadget skin in AfAPrefs is empty, the environment variables are deleted, so Birdy and Visual Prefs and or title shadow are used instead. But we don't want to use this. If you select the skin, the environment variables will be set. Okay, newer versions of AmiKit come with activated skin system by default. So we need to have a variable. If not exists, replace visual prefs. Okay, environment variable, replace visual prefs. What we can do about that is come here, see, set env, it is env. Set name and string, no, set env, yes, come on, set env. Okay, so what we can do is create an environment variable. We can do that with set env command, and as we can see here, we set the name and the string and save. We can say save. If you have the argument save here, then this environment is going to be saved on Envark as well. Otherwise, it is going to be saved only in env assign, and after boot, this is going to be lost. So set env, save. The path that we need to do is alpha slash replace visual prefs, and we will going to put just that. To be sure that this is saved on the right place, we can do dir env, okay, alpha, we have that file there, and we can do text edit env alpha replace. You see, it loaded the file and we have the value 1 there. Although that I don't think that it makes any difference what exactly value you are going to have in this environment. And let me check if this is Envark as well. Okay, it exists in Envark, and let's reboot and see if it works now and we have the skins enabled. After that, we are going to play a little bit with the skins and see if they work fine on our system or not, or if we need to do something else. Prefs. Okay, let me open it a little bit like that. No. This is not enabled. Why? Let's see again. We will be there. AfAOS. Maybe I'm hurrying a lot and I don't spend time to read all the documentation for the skin system. So if not exists, this one, if this variable does not exist, goes and loads title shadow and all the other patches. Okay, something that we don't want to do. Okay. Place visual prefs. If not exists, enable the following lines only. Okay. Okay, in the drawer skins you find a file named blacklist info. In this file you can add programs to the tool types that should only use default border size. Yeah, if you want to exclude some programs from getting the skins, because they probably have issues with the other gadgets that they add there. This is useful as well. For performance reasons, blacklisting was designed as simple as it could be for the CPU. Okay, first comes XXXX, can be used later for options, then the task name. Okay. Yeah, so we have to understand here the logic. If not exist, replace visual prefs. Okay, it runs that. We don't want to run them, then it uses the Omega FP prefs. Okay, conclip. This is a path. Replace, if not exists, replace birdie. Yeah, actually, these lines is something that AmiKit was doing, because depending what the user wants to do, it was disabling or enabling the AfAOS. Later on, when you have fully switched to the AfAOS skin system, AfAOS skins can be changed in real time. Okay. The environment variables are deleted, so birdie, visual prefs, and or title shadow are used. Possibly that's the reason. Because the string gadget skin in alpha prefs is empty right now, so it probably deletes that environment variable. Let's see if it is right. If I go to dir env alpha. Yeah, it is not there. And the reason for that is because of what it says here. When the string gadget skin in alpha prefs is empty, the environment variables are deleted. Okay, so what can we do to make it not empty? Let's see. Let's see if there is a... force skin and skin path, let's say that. Okay, if you, this is necessary if you want to move the skins somewhere else in another folder. This is very useful because you can set here another path for your skins. So if we do the force skin, let's see the if there is any documentation about the tool types. Did the installer work? Alpha prefs program. Okay. Not have with not function with AfAOS. What is AfAOS? What is the purpose? Window. Okay. Yeah, actually it should at least this should be enabled so I can set something there. Okay, let's reboot. Possible if you have Birdie installed or the other software, it might make this field enabled, but I don't know. Let's see if we can avoid to install all this stuff just for that. No. No, I don't see any predefined, nothing. I'm looking for any preferences that might be predefined, but I don't see anything like that. If I go and last saved, no, reset to defaults, nothing, and restore, nothing. So yeah, it doesn't work like that. Okay. Let's see SLD snake. Let's see if we can find a workaround to make it work. AfAOS. Also, let me check again the archive. Maybe there is something in the archive. Let me extract it again in RAM and see if they have any configuration there. I find a little bit weird to need to install other applications just to have the fields enabled. That's why, for me at least, it doesn't make sense. But so until I check everything, I will try to avoid to install visual pref. On the other hand, we have visual prefs installed, so we can try that. Put the logic that they have in the documentation, put it there in the startup sequence and see if it works just with visual prefs. Otherwise, let's see, it's another question about Alpha prefs. Why are the sliders for the titles ghosted? If the intuition library, icon library, and more lib space installed and functioning. For title size gadget ghosted. Okay. Why have no preview of the transparency if I move the sliders? Okay, that's not our problem. Why I see no effect? Nothing. Okay. General questions. Why are the AfAOS libraries? How can I make sure the AfAOS installed properly and start correctly? It is best to use the program Snooptos. You there? Okay. You require? Okay. Under 3.1. Yeah, let's see that. You require the three file set paths of Workbench library and icon library of OS 3.5 or 3.9 to enable it. To enable the skinning. This file. are needed. These files are needed because the workbench do in turn icon drawing. This means the OS function draw icon state is not used in workbench, and OS 3.1 icon lib does not contain this function, and set patch is needed to remove the ROM based libraries to use the files in libs. The following is to do: rename set patch to set patch old, copy these libraries. Okay, that's for 3.1. I hope that these steps are not needed in our situation. Okay, let's see what we can do. If it fails, we might go with the solution to try to use Birdie and Visual Prefs in our system. Okay. What is here? Okay, not needed, I guess. Okay. This free type library is needed for the font support. Okay. For the true type fonts. Logo not needed, optional, and test prog. I don't see something here. Okay, next move. I will open the system, AfAOS. And the guide. And then the text edit to load the startup sequence. And AfAOS installation here. Let's go here. Unfortunately, we can't select here the text, so I have to type everything. So I press wait here. Okay. If not exists env. Hello Falcon 11, welcome to the stream. No reminder from Twitch? Oh my god. Alpha replace visual prefs. Today, Falcon, we try to make our AmigaOS look better, AmigaOS 3.2, with a bigger resolution and much more colors on the screen. That's why we enabled a bigger resolution, which is 1024x768. And I'm using the emulated Amiga because we need some more power than the classic 1200 that I have, and we also need an RTG graphics card. And now I'm trying to make AfAOS work on this system, but it has some issues. We will see if we can make it work. Actually, just a reminder, right now we have one of the libraries of AfAOS, the one that is for iconlib, we have that disabled. I don't know if that's the reason why we don't see the skins. It might be the reason. And also have in mind that we have in prefs, since we booted, right now we have the safer system enabled, so we can try to move again the icon library inside the folder where everything is running at the boot, in case that this checkbox, this safer system checkbox, enables something with the icon library and works well on our system. But first, let's do what the documentation says here. So if not exists, alpha replace visual prefs. Okay, we can run the visual prefs here, and we can add here an end if. And then it does a wait for 1 second, prevents iprefs from crashes, increases the value if iprefs still crashes. Okay, iprefs, and let's do that. Let's put some wait here, wait 2, for example, and then it goes on. Okay, save. And let's reboot and see what it happens. Now, logically, it should enable the visual prefs, because if you remember in preferences, AfAOS says in the documentation that if the field of the skin is not enabled, then it clears the environment variable. We can see that here. Dear env alpha, it clears this environment, so we don't see anywhere anything here. So logically, the visual prefs is running right now. Let's see if we can see that on Exchange. No, it's not visible here, and we don't have Scout here installed. Let's bring Scout. We will need it, aminet.net. You remember Scout, we saw that tool in previous streams, and sorry, and it is pretty good to see what exactly is running on your system. It's one of the essential utilities for AmigaOS. Actually, I use it on every OS, AmigaOS flavor, AmigaOS 3, 4, and Morphos, because it is quite useful. So let's see, we have Scout here. Yeah, not W. I have to change that. And that doesn't need an installation, so I'm going to extract it in applications. Great. So right now, if I go here, Scout, yeah, and you remember that tool, right? Tasks, logically somewhere here we will see the visual prefs. No, this is running, okay, yeah, here it is. We have visual prefs running just fine. Okay, exit. Let's put that here as well because we might need it again. Great. And let's see if we get anything here. No, nothing. This is not enabled. Okay, one more try. Otherwise, we are going to go to use the visual prefs and Berti and see how we can use these tools, which are quite old, but they might do the work that we need to do. The thing that I want to try again is to move here in AfAOS libraries, the icon lib paths, this one, and see if our system is going to boot right now and if we can enable the skins. Let's see. Falcon 11 says the tab key don't want to find Dota. Why? I don't have a clue. You mean on the Twitch stream, I guess. The Twitch chat, or you are using another tool. Try to use the okay, it fails, unfortunately, so we are going to boot again. And go with the old way. Go with the Berti. I wonder if we can use only AfAOS for the true type fonts. And for the skinning, we can use Berti and visual prefs. So let's see if we can do that. As soon as it boots. The bad thing is that we can't use the AfAOS skins with Berti and visual prefs. But I can show you where you can find some skins for these programs as well. So let's have AfAOS. Yeah, it seems that this icon lib fails big time and the system doesn't reboot with that. Falcon 11 says you use Kickstart 3.1 in emulator. No, I use the 3.2. Livelord says, how is visual prefs working in AFAOS 3.2? Livelord, I haven't tried that yet, but it should work just fine because after the release of AmigaOS 3.2, there was an update for the visual prefs. So I don't expect that we are going to have any issues with that. Falcon 11 says, why don't 3.2? Yeah, 3.2, I'm using 3.2 ROM. Let me check that again. Yeah, what I'm doing. Yeah, I'm using 3.2, otherwise I wouldn't have these early startup extra options. Is there any issues with it? With level, you say, with the, with what? You know what, Falcon 11, you might be right about the ROM. Let me check again. But I'm pretty sure that I was using the 3.2 ROM. Let's reboot the system. Yeah. Now it's the right one, right? Yes. Now I recall that. Yeah, I think that we were using on emulated Amiga the 3.1 because when we started the streams, we targeted the 3.1 kickstart because that's the one people had, right? Let me make the screen look better. I hope you see that much better right now. The reason that we were doing that is because when we started these streams, we targeted the Amigas with Workbench with Kickstart 3.1 because it was not available for everyone to have the 3.2. And that's the reason why we had the 3.1 in our system. Right now I enabled the 3.2, and let's see that when we boot in the early startup. $47.96. So thanks, Live a Lot, for that reminding. And yeah, let's boot in our system. And yeah, I'm going to. We have Birdie, we have Visual Prefs installed. I'm going to install right now the Birdie and try that solution for bringing skins in our system. But I will also leave the AfAOS running in case we can use the TrueType font support from that. I hope the screen is looking good on your stream. So let's move on. And IBrowse, we can find Birdie on Aminet, and actually the name of the archive is Birdie 2000, and that's the version 2000. So let's download that. Okay, and let me do one more thing before we move on. I would like to enable in Magic User Interface the iconification icon here, those two, so I can minimize that and not close and every time. So yeah, we have here in downloads the Birdie. Birdie is an interesting application released a long time ago, and it's interesting because you can set whatever patterns you want into your borders of the windows, so you can make really funky window borders on your system. For example, let's see if we can run something with the patterns that come with the application. First of all, let me move it to applications here. You can have it wherever you want. And Birdie, It's a program that you have to add in startup sequence because it only runs from the shell. Okay, so birdie. Let's open the readme. No. Okay. Drop it here. The readme says how we can use it, I guess. Not this one. This one. Okay. So birdie has some arguments. And you can set birdie pattern 1, pattern 2. Okay. For example. So we have here some patterns. Let's see if we can run it now. 001 JPEG and patterns 002 JPEG and patterns 003 JPEG. You see, it changes the look of the windows, the window borders, and whenever you open a window, selects one of these patterns that you add in the as arguments in a random order and opens that. But what we want to do is to have two patterns, to use two patterns, two different patterns. And one will be for the active windows and one for the inactive ones. So we can use, there is an argument here, if you can, let's find it, active pattern. If you use active pattern, the first pattern that is set here is going to be the active one. And then selects one randomly from the rest of the patterns. Let's cancel it. Okay. So it seems it works pretty good with the AmigaOS 3.2. So I'm going to open IBrowse and go and find a skin for the AmigaOS 3.2, a skin that we are going to use in our system, a skin that is going to have buttons for the gadgets, the close button, the order button, and all this stuff. And this skin is going to be used from Visual Prefs and Birdie to change the pattern on the windows. So I'm going to go to amigalook.org. This website is not working so well, at least it doesn't look so well on IBrowse, but it is working fine. If you go here on themes, there is AmigaOS 3.x, and there are a few packages that you can download as for the visual prefs. Let's find one. Let's say KenOS 4. This light one. And here it has a description. The theme includes images for visual prefs and birdie. Pointer and title shadow preferences are also included. Of course, the pointer is for the old pointer system that was on 3.1 and 3.9. We can use also the preferences of title shadow, but not the pointer preferences, right? So let me download this one. And downloads, okay. It's a pretty small package, so I'm going to open that. Where is it? Here it is. Also, those packages, the KenOS 4, is created by Ken Lester. No, actually, I'm going to put it inside presets. This one I'm going to rename to alpha skin. Oh no, let's leave it as it is, but create here one different, let's say, themes. Okay, and put here these themes. Okay, great. And here we have the folder KenOS 4 Lite. So right now, if I do birdie, let's see the arguments. Okay, birdie active pattern, and then add the, from here we have the active one PNG and inactive. Okay, come on. Need a space here. So right now you see that we have the active with the light blue color, and all the inactive are with the gray, but this degrade here. So birdies seems to work just fine, so I'm going to cancel that and take that, copy and paste it in our user startup, in our startup sequence, sorry. Let me make it bigger. Come on. And here, if not exists, okay, we have that run nil this. We can make that sys to make it a little bit smaller. I don't know if you know what this run nil means. Do you have a clue, guys, about this syntax here, nil, about the nil? SLT snakes, it looks, SLT snake says it looks good. I'll need to take a second look at the stream while trying myself on one of my systems or emulation. Yeah, it will look better. I promise you. Falcon 11 says, back to AfAOS. I'm not sure if can be AfAOS and Visual Prefs together, because in AmiKit are not together. Yeah, they are not. But if we can check the TrueType fonts, maybe the AfAOS is not patching the way that the window is looking. Because it leaves that part to the birdie and the visual prefs, but we might be able to use the TrueType fonts. We are experimenting, so we are going to test it. Falcon 11 says, yeah, we know Neil. Okay, that's fine. For those that do not know Neil, it's something like a device that consumes every output from any command. So if you don't want, if you try to run a command that does something and then puts out some output, it says that everything went okay or whatever, but you don't want this to come up in a shell window when you run it, in especially in startup sequence or user startup, you use this nil writing, and it goes to, yeah, it goes to null, it goes to nothing, so it doesn't print in your screen, exactly like Falcon 11 mentions on the chat. Thanks, Falcon 11. So right now we have the pattern, and let's load the preferences for the Visual Prefs. Let's have that running so it looks nice. And see Prefs. Here we have, do we have the Visual Prefs here or on system? Possibly on system. Visual Prefs. No. Let me see if it doesn't have. Yeah, it is GUI. I was looking for a preference program named Visual Prefs, but it is named GUI. Okay, and let's see how we can open that. Sys Prefs, themes, here, Visual Prefs, this one. File Sys Prefs contains only one screen definition. Do you want to add it to the current? Add, okay. Okay, we can do a lot of things here. Use, retry, okay, cancel. Let's save it and let's reboot. And see how we did it, if it works or looks fine or not. SLD snake says redirect to nowhere. Exactly, redirect to nowhere. And it is quite useful when you run things from user startup. It is perfect. Okay. So right now we have the Visual Prefs working, but I don't see the skin from Birdie for some reason. Okay, let's see if Birdie failed to load. Open S startup sequence here. Yes, of course. Birdie is not in the path, right? Leveler says, I hate that some items from Visual Prefs are overlapping with settings from OS 3.2. Can't remember just right now, but like height of Windows bars and look and feel. Yeah, that's logical to happen because these were things that were existing on Visual Prefs much before than AmigaOS 3.2 was released, right? So with Visual Prefs, you could do that. And the AmigaOS 3.2 developers tried to bring that features in the AmigaOS. To be honest, yeah, it is. I don't know if it should be prevented to overlap these changes, but I understand why this is happening. Now, Birdie is not running here because Birdie is in its own folder inside the applications, right? And it's not in the path. You can easily copy that to C if you want. Otherwise, you can get the path. Oh, come on. Install. Like that. Let me save it and reboot, and now it's going to work. Yeah, it was because it couldn't find Bertie from where to run it. Possibly if we were looking on the boot and the messages that we would get on the boot, we will see that Bertie is not there. It's not actually a command, so that's why it fails. And now we have everything. With title shadow, this application, we can add shadows here on the titles, which might look quite well. But now we have a very nice skin in our system, right? And we have the active and inactive windows, and looks good, in my opinion. Without ticking around with the visual prefs configuration, it is there, it looks nice. And if you go to amigalook.org, you can find different skins. If you don't like this one and you would like to have something else, you can find different skins and use something else. Libero says thanks, but does the overlapping have any negative effects? In my opinion, not really. I don't see any negative effect. Just that you don't change the height of the window through the preferences, the IC control of the preferences here. You are not able to change the height of the window here anymore. But you have to do it from the GUI. That's the only difference, in my opinion. Falcon 11 says, yet. Change system to sys in startup sequence. Yeah, you're right. I left it like that because it was only a small path, but you are right. We have to make it sys here. We can change it to sys. And sys, as you know, guys, it's the booting partition of the AmigaOS, right? Of course, there are a couple of colors like the bars that are not quite matching, this orange color, and also the border here that is bluish something at the top bar. If you would like, you can change that from the GUI. Come on, from here, this is possible to change. And yeah, Visual Prefs has so many configuration options that it takes time to figure out everything, how they work. But in my opinion, it is a solution that you can have a nice looking AmigaOS environment workbench. With a few clicks, you don't need to mess with it a lot. And also there are other themes. I believe that this one as well has configurations. No, this one needs AfAOS. But this one, this black one, this KenOS 4, and this AZ are also skins that can be used with Birdie and Visual Prefs. And I'm pretty sure that there are others out there. Unfortunately, Alpha didn't work as we would like. Let me open the prefs and see if changed nothing. Yeah, it seems that it needs some update or something so that this field is enabled. I will have a look the next days on that as well. And one of the last things that I would like to see is if we can use some better looking icons, because those are looking quite nice but are small, or they and they don't have. Right now we have a workbench that uses some millions of colors, right? So it would be nice if we could use some more colorful icons. And also check the TrueType fonts. Livelo says, while we are talking about AmigaOS in high-res, what would you do to improve look of the cell with a larger font and also to improve that small text in IBrowse? Okay, let's move to fonts, since Livelo says that, and see first of all if we can use fonts, better looking fonts, because right now you are right, we have small fonts on the cell, and on even bigger resolutions, let's say on 1080p resolution, they are not going to look well, they are going to be broken. So let's see if we can use the at least alpha feature of anti-aliasing. This seems to work here, at least. Let's see if we can use it on the system. With AfAOS, okay, we need TrueType fonts. Let's see if we have anything in our fonts folder. Okay, with AfAOS, there are a couple of these fonts installed, and we have the TrueType fonts installed. So let's see if we can use them in our system, first of all. And before I do that, let me close IBrowse and open fonts. Select workbench icon. We have here Vera Sans, right, which are true type fonts, and let me do that 20. Okay, I don't know if it is visible on, let me do that 32 on the stream. I believe it is. You see that the letters are shown quite nice, and there is anti-aliasing. You don't see this jingle at the corners of the letters. So if I go here and set it to, let's say, 20. Okay, maybe that's too far. 18. Okay, something like that. And system default also set the Vera mono, which is monospace fonts. And all these monospace fonts are used in cell. And for the screen text, let's also use Vera Sans at 18. Okay. Save. Yeah, I'm pretty happy to say that it looks like the AfAOS side for the TrueType fonts and the anti-aliasing and all this stuff is working fine. And you can see here the cell with a bigger font. C, oh no, dear C. And with this font, at least, it seems to look much better, right? Leave a lot. Of course, you can download fonts, TrueType fonts from the internet, free fonts, and then to install them, you just need to use the TrueType font manager from here and install them. Let's actually check first how we can use this fonts in IBrowse, and if there are any fonts in Aminet that we could download, TrueType fonts that we could download. Now you can see how better the buttons here are looking in Magic User Interface, because Magic User Interface takes the default fonts and use them, right? So if we go to, let's say, Aminet, not that picture, in Aminet, you will see that the letters inside the rendering area are not looking well, because actually right now they are still using the old fonts. Okay, so for changing that, we go to the where is it? Okay, settings here on preferences, and in HTML fonts. Okay. Here you can set exactly which fonts you would like to use on the rendering area. Libelo says, yes, it looks much better. That makes sense. I was just not aware how to make TrueType fonts to work with AmigaOS. Thanks for that. There are two ways to do that. One with the AfAOS, which for me it's preferable, because it works much better and it's much newer than the second solution. The second solution is to use some TrueType font manager and libraries that are still, I think they are still available on Aminet, but you have to do all the installation on your own, and they do not work that good like as AfAOS is working. So what you can do here is, as you can see, it still uses times. You can change that to, we have a Vera Sans here, so we are going to use this one. Select 15 as the smallest, and then let's do a range. It creates the sizes for the different heights of the sizes, and you will see that it adds the different sizes here. I don't believe that they are working quite well, this ranging. Maybe you need to adjust it a little bit, but you see right here, let me save it, it looks much better, right? Yeah, it works just fine. Maybe since we don't use any other feature from AfAOS, I would like to disable some of these patches, to be honest. But you have to experiment a little bit to disable a few things and see if the TrueType fonts are still working. We can do it if you want. But yeah, it looks much better. And let's see another website. Much, much better with these fonts, right? And of course, if you go to bigger resolutions, of course, it's you are able to select bigger fonts, so they are looking quite better on your screen. SLD Snake says, pretty workbench. Yeah, that's the our target. If we could do the skin with the AfAOS, we would have a much bigger selection of skins. We will see if I can find a solution for that. Liveler says, much better, my eyes will appreciate. Yeah, you're right, Liveler, because we are getting older and these things have to be readable, right? Because we are spending a lot of time on these machines and this operating system. Of course, all these things are not necessary if you just use your Amiga to play games, right? And on classic Amigas, these features are going to slow down a lot your machine. That's why it is preferable to do that whenever you have an RTG card on your system, because it is going to give you, it is not going to consume your cheap RAM, and because it uses the memory from your graphics card. Falcon Level says, yeah, have one eyes only. Livelo says, I'm practically going blind when using Amiga. Yeah, it depends. It depends what you are doing on your Amiga. If you are using low resolution, right now we have a 1024 to 768. And that's the same resolution that we have on the classic Amiga that I'm streaming from, right? But yeah, if you have anti-aliasing on your fonts, it looks much better. At least AmigaOS 3.2, AmigaOS 4.1 is just perfect. Yeah, yeah, that's true. But you can see, you with the AmigaOS 3.2 and a good graphics card, you can go up to 1080p. With all these changes, you can make it look even better. Let's go to find some nice icons and see if they work with the system. I'm going to os4depot.net. This is a website that is targeting mostly the AmigaOS 4 users. There are a few packages from Icon Designer, very nice packages with icons. Let's download one of them. Of course, these icons are using a lot of colors, and they are targeted for the 1080p resolutions, right? So they might look a little big, but let's see how they look. Did I save it here? Yeah. Let me move here. Although that the icons from AmigaOS 3.2 are still looking better, quite good. I would prefer for this kind of screens to have a more colorful icons, as long as they don't slow down my system, right? And where's it? Here it is. And let me create storage. Folder named icons and copy them here. It seems that the icon library, as you can see, doesn't recognize quite well these icons. I will stop that. Yeah. Unfortunately, we can't use these ones. Which is a little bit weird. Because they are glow icons, but probably they're not quite compatible with the icon library that we have in AmigaOS 3.2. SLD Snake says, I feel comfortable with my RTGs at 720p, but I think that the anti-aliasing will make my RTG even better. SLD Snake, in what kind of machine do you have these resolutions? What hardware do you use on that machine? Libelor says that resolution for me feels just right. Yeah, the 4:3 scaled resolution It's always right. I love all that free state of the workbench, and it is good for drawing, which is my main use for Amigas. I agree with you, Livelord. Falcon 11, I think that there are newer versions of Icon Library. Let me give it a try. A minute. I don't know if you guys are tired, but I would like to test it a little bit more on that and see if these libraries, which were released a few weeks ago, actually, if they are working or not. So let me download it here and break AmigaOS 3.2. Let's break it, if possible. Okay, no. I don't know if anyone of you tried those libraries with AmigaOS 3.2. Please tell me what you believe, if it is going to work or not. SLD Snake says, I tried 720p with CyberVision 64 on Amiga 4000 and an S3 Tri or PCI on Amiga 3000. Both at 16 bits and 32 bit with Warp 1260 and Amithron. SLD Snake, I believe that you have tried on really powerful machines, and yeah, that should work just fine. With no slowdowns, right? I don't believe that you would experience any slowdowns because of the resolution. Falcon 11 says, it's very interesting that Icon Lib from Peter K is not compatible with OS 3.2. What can I say on that? I don't have any comment. Livelord says, no, you can keep going if you can. Yeah, I'm full on that. Falcon, I don't try it, but heard only. Yeah, let's see if it works or breaks everything. And SLD Snake says, yeah, I always use that Icon Library from Peter. Awesome job, parallel to OS 3.x development. Have you tried that SLD Snake with AmigaOS 3.2? Because I know on previous versions it was working fine. But I don't know with AmigaOS 3.2 if it is working at all. Let's see how it goes. Okay. Program features, latest changes, installation. The installation depends on many things like CPU, ROM, OS. Okay. We have an O30 with FPU here. On most work with a workbench library version 44 plus, just copy my libs icon lib library into the libs. Okay. And we have 68020 icon library. The version 51 TC020 version is supplied in libs icon library now, which can be used on all systems. Okay, no, it does not need a graphics card, although it offers all the support for true color screens and icons in the best possible quality. Of course, it also works with native Amiga screen modes. needs at least an icon library version 47, so you can only install the 47 of the 51. Mm-hmm. Icon library is on 3.2, but it's still possible to call convert true color in case that you prefer to create faster 3.5 color icons. I'm a little bit confused right now. We have 46. Version icon. This is 47.4. And it says OS 3.2 needs at least an icon library version 47. So you can only install the version 47 or the version 51 icon libraries on 3.2. Okay. SLD Snake says icon library press 3.2. Yeah, I didn't notice any negative effect. And Level Lord says the same here. Icon lib is working for me too. Falcon 11, Peter K, icon lib I use always, but not with 3.2. Okay. SLD Snake says I noticed that this icon lib can read some special PNG icons from a software pack that I downloaded some time ago. Without the Peter K icon lib, the workbench cannot read any icons from this LHA software pack. The icons that it doesn't show the workbench from that pack are replaced with a small dot SLD. If this Falcon 11 says if this is working, then I had heard bad. Yeah, let's see if it works, but it. I need to understand which one should I use here. Third party, auto update, okay, fbleed, copy icon. Yeah, we don't want to use any of these. Bonus, icon lib. Okay. And let me also check something from the prefs. And the workbench. This is not needed anymore. Quality best, no border. Okay. Save. Okay. So if I copy this library, this is version 46.4, and based on what it says here, the 3.2 should not use it because it expects to have 47. So is there another here? Don't see any other. Okay, let's be bold and rename icon.library to icon library underscore 47.4. Okay, and copy this one to libs. SLD Snake says, I'll check again that pack. I'm curious now. Yeah, because if it is showing a small dot, usually you will see that this might happen because of a checkbox, of this checkbox. If it is a new icon and this is enabled right here, then icons are not supported and are replaced by a small dot. You uncheck that and it should work just fine. Just give it a try. Falcon 11 says icon library TC020 can use. Okay, but the thing is, where is that? Because in libraries I don't see this one, and here on bonus there is only the LD. I don't see any TC. I think icon lib version 51 is from OS 4.1. Yeah, possible. Yeah, it's not here, and possibly this line is from older versions. Okay, let's reboot and see. And if it fails, we know what we did wrong and we can fix it. SLD Snake says Falcon 11 TC020 is good for RTG or powerful Amigas, right? If I'm not mistaken. Okay. So it fails. Okay, let me reboot and see if we can boot in safe mode. But the thing is that this was released recently, so I would expect that the AmigaOS 3.2 is taken in mind before the release. So let's see if we can, yeah. Okay. We don't have any icons. So let's reboot with no startup sequence and fix that problem. It's not a big deal, SLT Snake. we can fix it. That's the thing with AmigaOS, that it is possible to be fixed pretty easily, right? Exactly, Falcon 11, no startup sequence, and we can be here. We can go see libs with a dir here. We can see everything and rename or delete icon library. And rename icon library to icon library like that. And reboot, and it's going to be fine. That's why I always keep backups of the file in case something is going wrong. No worries, Falcon 11, no worries. Yeah. So let's have a final look what we did right here, right now. We have in our emulated Amiga enabled the Picasso with high resolutions. We can go even on resolutions like, okay, like 1080p. Which is crazy, because back in the days we couldn't even imagine this kind of resolutions, right? And the applications of AmigaOS are able to use them, and the workbench is able to use it just fine. And yeah, it is possible to go in these resolutions. And I know that it's not possible to see that on the stream, but yeah, it works fine. We have 32-bit on our workbench for colors, and also we have anti-aliasing TrueType font support. and we managed to use TrueType fonts in IBrowse and also on Magic User Interface, and we can we also used skins for our windows to make the windows look much better. Unfortunately, AfAOS didn't work with AmigaOS 3.2, but this is something that we can experiment a little bit more and see if it it's able to work, if we can make it work. SLT Snake says, good piece of hardware, that B Vision. Yeah, it is very nice. Is that the RTG card that if it was not supported under P96 until some updates ago? Yeah, SLT Snake, I used to, with my B Vision on another machine that I have, I used Cyber Graphics, but I think that the Picasso, only the latest versions are able to work with that. And also, if you have a B Vision, probably you have a PowerPC on your machine, right? And if you install on that AmigaOS 4, the classic version, it's crazy that you can use on that graphics card 1080p resolution just fine with no slowdowns. It works pretty good. Falcon 11 says, audio problem. You can hear me right now quite well or not? Is there still that problem? Falcon 11 says, I think now it is supported by Picasso 96, but I still use Cyber Graphics 4. I have created pointers specifically in mind for high-res AmigaOS, as I was constantly on the lookout wearing my mouse pointer, one red and one white theme style, like Linux Mint pointer. Livelord, that is quite interesting. Did you upload it on Aminet for others to download it? Falcon, can you hear me better now? Okay, guys, probably only Falcon has on his side, the problem with the audio. I hope you can be heard quite well. Livelo says, I will as soon as I complete full set. Yeah, please do, because this kind of work should be shared. We see there are additional images like dragging text and so, yeah, that's cool. And yeah, that's all that I would like to show you today, guys, on the, let's see how IMP is working. Great, it looks fine. So thank you guys for being here. Thank you for joining me on the stream today. Thank you for your support and for being here all the time. SLD Snake says, oh, I think I saw some recent upload on a Terminet focusing at the high-res pointer. Oh, I have to take a look on that. Thank you for being here, guys. Thank you for staying up to now. Let me see. Yeah, we have music. And SLD Snake says, this Sunday, second chapter of Amiflon, live running system. We ran out of time the last week. Yeah, go, guys, and see the stream that SLD is doing with the Amiga Wave people. It is in Spanish, but SLD Snake shows so many interesting things there. Last week he had a very nice presentation about Amiflon, and I'm sure that this week is going to be awesome as well. So it is going to be SLD Snake is going to be on Sunday night again. Please share more info on the chat for others to follow as well. Yeah, I'm going to be there, or otherwise I'm going to watch it the next day, the recording. And yeah, thank you very much. Let's see if anyone is streaming right now and rate them. Let's see who we can rate. Let's go and raid let's see, AF Retro I think is streaming, so let's go there. AF Retro streams usually games, retro games using his old Macintosh, PowerPC Macintosh machines. It's quite interesting streams, and I'm sure you are going to have fun. Let's rate him, and thank you again for your support, guys, and for being here. I hope that this stream was interesting. And we had our issues, but we are going to solve them at the end. Thanks a lot. Have a good rest of the day, and take care. See you next time. Bye bye, everyone.